Eric Sorby, Haines City, Florida, and I'm here with realmotocross.com. The life of a pro rider, it's not that easy. I mean, if you want to be a pro rider and be really good at what you're doing, motocross, supercross, you have to be dedicated every day, like waking up and just train and ride, and that's the only thing you should do every day if you want to be good. I mean, pro rider, I think anybody can get a pro license, but it depends how you want to be. You want to be just pro rider to say you're pro and try to pick up chicks, or pro rider and be on top. Life after racing sucks. Why? Because when you race, like I say, wake up, train and ride, and go home, chill, party. And life after racing, it's kind of like a 9-to-5 job. Right now, I'm not really in this position because I have the opportunity to have a great job for right now, but I think it's going to be tough when one day I'm going to have to have a real job, so it's life. To work with James Stewart, everybody watches the TV show and think like we just play around and go party and fly on private jet and all the rock star life. Yeah, what you see, that's not what it is. To work for James Stewart, it's really hard, you know. The guy, he ride a lot and train every day, and when he ride and train, and I'm just right behind him doing the same thing, and it's not easy because when I used to race, I never really trained. I was just riding and just, I was just good at it, so I never really have to work hard to be on top of the game. So now, the life with James Stewart, it's hard, and it's a lot of things. Like, you gotta be prepared, you know. Like, it's so much media come to him, and I'm kind of like his personal assistant. So I'm the good guy and the bad guy at the same time, you know. I gotta push people away from him at the race because he needs to have his own time, and the good side to be with James Stewart is, I mean, first, he's a really good friend of mine and I know him for 10 years, and every time he do something cool, I have the opportunity to go with him, and it can be anything, going helicopter, private jet, going to a concert, everywhere you go pretty much and do something fun, I have the opportunity to go with him. So, I mean, I like this side. The other side is kind of stressful, but like I say, after pro racing, you gotta have a normal job. I would say racing, the first race I did, and it was March 2002 in Houston. That was my first race in America, and since I was a little kid, my goal was to go in America and race pro, supercross, and be on a podium. And it always been a dream since I was like 10 years old. And when I came to America, and I did in the first race too, I will never forget about that night, especially the last lap. I mean, I could not believe, like, I was like, damn, I'm going to be on the podium, and I'm in America, that's where all the top best rider in the world, and I'm right here, third, and that was the best, like, memory of racing. I mean, after that, I have a lot of podium, motocross, supercross, but I did care, but my goal was to be one time on the podium. I never came to America and say I'm going to win a championship. That's I never wanted to win a championship. Why? I don't know. Because I like to do a lot of different things in my life, and I did what I was supposed to do. My goal, be on the podium, which I did plenty of times. And after that, I wanted to be on TV, and that's what I'm doing right now. And I got a lot of projects for the future. So that's it. Loving you. Yeah, I mean, I've been working on the Frenchie closing line for the, I would say, for the past 5 months. And why Frenchie? Why the name of Frenchie? Like, because Bubba's World, the reality TV show, and a lot of people call me Frenchie because I'm from France, in case you can tell by my accent. So, yeah, just making some clothes and try to make the fan happy, and that's it. I know I'm not gonna get rich out of it, but. And make people happy. rider. Well, if you want to be at a top level racing, you have to be dedicated, and you gotta work every day hard, like training and riding and as much as possible. If you're lucky, like some of the rider, like let's take an example, Ricky Carmichael is a really good rider, but he doesn't have as much skill as James Stewart. Ricky Carmichael got to train every day, working on technique and doing moto all day long, and going to the gym and going bicycle and all this, because he doesn't have those skills. And on the other side, you got a guy like James Stewart. Well, he works hard, but different than Ricky. He pretty much, he just ride every day, and yeah, that's it. I mean, it's my advice is, if you're lucky to have some skill on the motorcycle, just use it and ride as much as possible, and take this as a hobby first. And if you start going up and winning race, it is, you can be pro and really good and make some good money. Thank you for listening. That was Eric Sorby on realmotocross.com. Stop the Facebook, switch to the real website, Motocross Fan, realmotocross.com.